Hey, it's Nick with Table 19 Media. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to do your bracketing settings for Sony A-series cameras. Now, I do my real estate photography with a Sony A7 III that allows me to shoot bracketed photos or HDR photography, which is essentially taking multiple exposures of the same image at different exposure levels and then merging them together in post-production in a software like Lightroom. This allows you to get detail in the highlights, but also detail in the shadows and merging them so you get the best of both worlds. Currently, the A7 III is about $2,000. And this can also be done with a cheaper camera like a Sony A6400 or 6600, even an A7C. It's all gonna be about the same kind of process to do it. Now, even though this video is about Sony A series, you could even follow these same steps to shoot on a Canon, you know, T8i or something like that. That's gonna still allow you to do bracketed photos. First thing you're going to want to do is to switch your camera into manual mode. This allows you to control each little setting individually. Now we're going to switch to bracketed photos, and you can choose anywhere from 3 to even 9 images in a single bracket. Now I recommend that you probably stick with, you know, 3 or even 5. I usually shoot 5 because a lot of the times I'm shooting condos and I need to make sure that I'm getting a nice crisp, even exposure outside the window as well as inside, which it can be very dark. But in most cases, you can probably get away with just using 3 exposures. And choosing 3 or 5 exposures, you wanna make sure that you set it to 2 stops between each exposure. So you're gonna line up the exposure on 0 and then it'll be 2 stops above and 2 stops below. That allows you to get enough information in the highlights and the shadows as well as in the middle. Also really important is to set the self timer to either 2 or 10 seconds. This allows you to just hit the button once and then the camera will count down to 2 or 5 seconds and then take the photos. This way you're not manually touching your camera each for each exposure, which can bump it and then the images won't line up exactly how they should. Now, when it comes to shooting the photos, what we're going to do is lower our ISO to 100. This allows us to get the clearest image possible without using any extra artificial light to brighten the image. Now on our lens, we're gonna set our lens aperture to 8 or above. So it'll be 8, 10, 12, but usually I set mine to about 8. That allows that most of the image is going to be in focus for the most part. There might be some things that are very, very far away that might be a little bit out of focus, but everything that's in the immediate area is going to be in focus. Now we're gonna use our shutter speed to darken or brighten our image based on our meter at the bottom, our exposure meter at the bottom. So what I usually do is increase or decrease the shutter speed so that the line is just below 0. For me, I'd rather err on the side of underexposing the image just a tad bit, which I can bring up, as opposed to getting something that's maybe too overexposed on the 2 stops on the highest exposure. So I usually just 1 tick below 0, and then I can take a picture. We'll hit the shutter button and then let the camera take the 3 or 5 exposures. And then we're gonna take those exposures and move them into Lightroom. For a video on how to merge them together in a program called Lightroom, check out this video above where I explain how you can actually batch all of your images together so that Lightroom merges them automatically together, saves you a lot of time instead of having to do it manually. So go ahead and check out that video for that whole process. All right, I hope that video is helpful for you to get started really quickly. I'm Nick with Table 19 Media. Make sure that you check out the links below for some of the gear that we use, but also some of our courses that we've put together for mobile photography, mobile video, but also a new course that we're coming out with soon that teaches you everything for photos, video, and drone. I've shot hundreds of millions of dollars of real estate photos, video, and drone. Now I want to show you how to do it so you can build your own business or handle it all in-house for your company. Don't waste valuable time searching for info or tutorials that may not even be what you need. I'm going over the gear you need to get started that won't break the bank. And I'll teach you the knowledge and skills you need to produce vibrant images and beautiful videos that sell properties and increase rental bookings. You can be a complete newbie or have any amount of experience. Whether you are a real estate agent or assistant, rental sharing owner, property manager, or looking to start or grow your real estate photography business, this is the course for you. Plus, you get mentor access to me to ask questions along the way. Click the link below to get started.